You are now listening to the Inner Circle Podcast Network.
I've been on Friday.
You did?
Yeah, and then on Cobra, I did that Cobra with Poison Boyz.
How was that? Bro, that fool was rolling off of acid, dog.
What the fuck?
Three tabs. I seen him pop two while I was there.
I'm just like, yo.
Rolling while DJing just seems fucking too intense.
It wasn't rolling. That was a fucking acid trip.
Okay, tripping while DJing.
Yeah, that fool was tripping.
Tripping while DJing just seems like it's too much. Like, I feel like the mixes just aren't going to sound right to everybody else.
I'm going to say this.
I think that it's just with that style of music, it's something that you don't have to really mix too.
Right. The transitions are
just puts you in this trance.
Aren't the main focus?
No. He plays trap music. He plays like trap hip hop.
Oh, okay.
So there's not. Yeah. So you don't think he really
has
to.
Okay. So you gotta freak that shit.
Yeah. I mean, he just been playing banger after banger after banger after banger type.
Yeah. It's a nice
way to do it.
It's a nice mix. You know what I'm saying? Because it's literally like today's music. It's not throwback. It's not Latin. Well, he plays some Latin here and there. But primarily, it's literally the new shit. Like, if you want to be a first on shit, go listen to his set. Because he'll drop a lot of new shit. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Hey, I shazammed a shitload of music that this dude was playing the other day. Yeah, dog. You played a lot of deep, dope shit, too. Because he was excited. He was like, dude, I get to play what the fuck I want today. I get to play shit that, like, I don't get to play at other places and shit. Right? That's what you were telling me the other day.
Off tops, it's always, like, a good time, like, whenever I get to play an event and something like that. Especially where it's an event that nobody's going to be dancing. You know, I'll be more able to play, you know, just, like, you know, they're just... But except for the whole entire night. The entire night. That same dude that's in a questionable barber battle... Judge scam just kept requesting that I play reggaeton.
He was,
and no
he
one was dancing, like, no one was dancing to it. No one was, and he just like, yo, play some reggaeton, bro. Play some reggaeton.
That's because it was
hey,
a lot.
I'm gonna tell you this, I tell him no requests, straight up. And if I like the song, I'll fucking play it. If it's whack, I ain't playing shit. And if it don't fit the vibe, bro, straight up, I ain't playing. Like at Cobra. When there's no one on the dance floor, there ain't really no reason to be playing reggaeton, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or cumbias.
Right.
You know? I go like fucking alternative rock sometimes. I'll fucking play like Deftones or fucking Fallout
you
Boy.
You read the crowd, right?
For sure, for
that's
sure. But
that's like a place where you can definitely
that's
play
that's a unique place in itself because it's an arcade.
Right. Okay.
So, but saying that, like...
You get everybody in there.
You can play David Bowie. You can play fucking Los Tigres. You can play fucking Prince. You can play... REM, you could, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you make it work, it could work. But, you know, at the barber battle, that's hip hop, bro. I've DJed a barber battle before. That's hip hop, dog.
Yeah, exactly. And you're trying to play, you know, more fast paced, you know, or more intense. Not intense, like, it doesn't have to be, like, super intense, but it's got to be, like, more upscale.
I feel like it helps the vibe. It helps the
vibe.
Like, when
you go, you're in a barber shop.
If I'm down there cutting.
That's what they play in a barber shop. You go in a barber shop and they're playing hip hop.
And you're playing something slow and shit. I'm going to be like, come on, dog. Like, I need something, like, to get me into this groove. And that's what he was doing. He was playing a whole lot of shit. It was good shit, man. That was fucking dope. We had a good ass time, man.
Yeah, especially because I was dead. I DJed at COVID the night before, and then I DJed from like 11 to 1.
That was a marathon, dog.
Bro, it's always a marathon. It's a long shift there. That
I
extra
do 9 to 2, bro.
It's just that extra hour that always kills. Like, it's just that 9 to 10. It always seems like it's like, dog, that extra hour just makes all the difference. Like, 4 hours, not a problem.
You know, I'm going to be honest with you. I feel like I put the groundwork in the first hour and a half of maintaining whoever's at the bar and building a vibe going forward.
Yep. That's the best hour to do it.
Because in the first hour and a half, you're going to have people in there that are just in for a drink and they're heading out. But if you can make them stay and you make that bar look like it's popping, then people just keep coming and coming and coming. Like, it's such a beautiful thing when you have a full dance floor and then they're like five deep the entire bar down. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
just seeing a sea of people there, bro. That's why I like playing on Saturdays as opposed to any other day.
And you also get to set a mood from the entire, you know, beginning of the night. You know, who knows what the bartenders were playing in there before you walked in, you know, but luckily it's only 9 p.m.
Right.
So you get that extra hour to build that relation and build what clientele you're going to bring in there. You know, when you hope for the best, you know.
Definitely, because there's nights that are dead on Saturdays.
And there's theme nights, you know, and some of those theme nights don't always go.
Bro,
like,
did you stop in when Selena was, when I did the Selena night?
I didn't, but I heard that it was super popping, super, super popping.
there. It was popping. I was driving by and shit. It was packed as fuck.
Oh, you didn't even stop and see your man?
Well, I had my lady with me. We were going home.
You guys could have got down.
It's a perfect time. Could have
got
down
with the fucking line that was there, homie. It was out the fucking door.
All you got to do is call me.
Oh, yeah. I got it like that.
Like that.
Oh, shit.
And you ain't paying for drinks.
Well, I'm there.
And you ain't paying for drinks. Like, bro, they fucking show so much love at Cobra.
Always.
Like, I can get a bottle if I want it.
Always. Yo, they're always like, yo, just bring in all your friends. We'll give you guys a bottle. Let's just get it popping. The whole point is just to get it more. The thing I was always, I'm always trying to do at Cobra is just to get more people dancing. Because it is an arcade. You know, there's definitely a lot less dancing there. But that's one thing, you know, there's some nights there'll be everybody dancing. And then some nights there'll be nobody dancing. But the bar is just packed. The place is packed except for the dance floor. Seem like no one's trying to dance, but everybody's, you know, hanging out, having a good time.
Right.
The place is packed wall to wall, but nobody on the dance floor.
Yeah. You know what I was going to ask you guys? What is the best website to find information about a DJ?
I'll be real with you. Doing gigs.
No, the best website.
What do you mean?
The best what is the best website to go to find information about
to learn?
DJ? Yeah.
Trial and error, bro.
Let me tell you what it is. Wikipedia.
Oh my god. How long were you sitting on that? How long were you sitting on that, motherfucker?
It was pretty quick.
No. This whole plan,
I always have to have something to fucking check. I have to have something to fucking where the drop comes in, okay? I have to, so do the drop.
Order up, order up.
This is a certified hood classic.
You are now tuned into the Hood Diner Podcast with your hosts, DJ Century and the homie Casual.
I don't even know where I was going with this. I'm fucking high as fuck.
After like the 100th time, it's all
What up, this is DJ Century.
And I am the homie Casual, and you are tuned into the Hood Diner Podcast.
My name is DJ Alva.
We get to introduce you, bro.
Do you like my beard?
Frog with you.
Damn! I had to do that drop.
I'm just fucking with you.
I like your beard. Yo, shout out to homie Gibbs.
Dude, the homie DJ Alva is in the building. His young brother Dre is also in the building with us. What's up, guy? How y'all doing?
What's back?
Me and Alva hung out this Sunday, man. So that's why I was like, you know what? I got to bring Alva in just as a thank you for me being able to leave all my equipment right there. Like, if you had to put a number, like everybody in there that had equipment, our equipment probably added up to the most. But the good thing about it was up on the stage. I don't think anybody was going to fuck with our shit up there because it would have had to have been in front of fucking everybody. There would have had to have been one witness as to...
Well, you're on stage, right?
Yeah.
So you got to go around the way, up the stairs. It's not like a very easy access.
Hey, dude, but you know what?
But there's a lot of people coming up because they're doing awards, they're doing everything else on stage.
But let me tell you this, though, because going into it, I didn't know he was the DJ.
Okay.
I had no idea. I hadn't really checked out, like, the full fucking flyer and shit.
Right.
And, I didn't know he was a DJ, so I, like, from the time I got there, I was like, all right, dude, like, where the fuck am I gonna leave my shit? Because I'm not gonna haul my backpack around with me.
It's all a little janky
day
in there.
And then if you see the fucking
the pisser,
if you see my shit.
Ooh, the bathroom is rough.
Oh, it is.
Janky.
Dude, no, you should. Oh, yeah, where did I.
It feels
I
like that you should shoot porn in there. Oh. Real talk. Real talk.
Dude, they got like those glass.
I was smiling
they got
at
those
some
glass
chick.
Wow, wow.
Because she was standing right by the door. And when the door opens, you just see me over there. And I'm just like pissing. I'm like,
there's probably a straight glory hole in that bathroom somewhere.
Probably.
At one point.
It's
at
like, you see the owner? It's behind like the.
You seen the owner?
Oh, yeah. I see the owner.
Like slash hair. From Goods and Rosen. Yeah.
Okay.
He was walking there for around like he's a fucking member of Quiet Riot and shit.
He was there for a little bit.
Yeah. No, remember he came in and he said that he had the best costume. He was a dude that said he had the best costume.
That was him?
That was him.
Well, oh, so he came back later then because he was there during the party thing.
Okay,
or the winners.
So last time I seen that dude, even before that, the last show that I DJ'd, he came in a totally different outfit than that, dressed like kind of like he was a swinger, like he was just like a sex crazed demon.
Hey, man. I mean, club owner, why not?
Well, you're looking at one.
I was like, that fool was going ham,
dude. If I was a club owner, I'd be a certain type of fella. You know what I'm saying? Like, I went to the back. Oh, remember? Okay, I had never been there since they remodeled it and shit. And like, I was up on stage. I seen Olive up there, and I seen him come down, but I didn't see him come back out. And I was like, I go to the hallway. I'm like, where the fuck did he disappear to? And I went down a little bit more, and there's like a little green room, a new green room back there. I'd never seen it. Fool was back there eating tacos and shit, all chilling. I'm like, what the fuck is this? But then they got an upstairs.
They got an upstairs.
Did you see all that?
Yeah,
like those stairs that go up.
They've had the upstairs part even since before they remodeled.
Okay,
but honestly,
what goes on up there?
Honestly, before that, well, it's kind of just like a little spot so the people the talent, you know, that they hire, whatever, can go up there and watch.
So that's another green room and shit up there?
It's just a little ledge, honestly. So you can just see out to the crowd.
Corner?
Yeah, I guess, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey.
But yeah, so it's just like a lookout. You know how, like, I don't know if you've ever been to Solar Culture, but at the top they got like a little ledge up there, maybe for some lighting at the time. I don't know if you can use lights in there.
Right.
However they do it. But yeah, there's like a little spot up there.
Well, that was a cool spot, dude. But anyways, dude, we go on tangents and shit, but back to the story, dude. That's what I wanted to tell you was thank you for me being able to leave my shit up there, dude. That was cool.
Always, bro.
And then because I was doing like, I was taking turns with each camera. I had three different cameras going, dog, and I would go down, and the biggest fucking beast is the fucking gimbal, you know what I'm saying? And I have a fucking handle on that. People are all staring at me crazy when they see me coming around with the big old screen and everything like that. And so anyways, doing my rounds and shit like that, so that's where I was able to leave my shit there and shit. So, dude, thank you for that shit. That was fucking dope.
For sure, bro.
And then
DJ booth is the safest place in the club, real talk.
Bro, dude, girls leave their purses in the DJ booth because they know that, you know, we're not going to take nothing.
Right? That was all suspect all the way.
Yeah, that was
quiet as shit.
He's all right. They know we're not going to take nothing, right? Right, guys? Right?
No, I came up on a girl's purse at the DJ booth one time.
There's been times, you know, like that I'll, like, you know, after I finish my set at the club, that I'll go and check out somewhere else, you know, go hang out with my friends for a little bit, come back, and I'll leave my backpack
at
the DJ
booth. Right there all day.
And that's, you know, that's got my whole entire, you know, lifeline as far as all my music and everything, as far as to do gigs and things like that.
Yeah, man.
And everything else, as well as personal information and everything else. So,
what's the new controller you got?
So I got the Denon MCX 8000.
Okay,
that number's so high, I just know it's
that's just a lot. Of
it's
numbers.
An 8000.
Like know why
the one
8,
I bought was like a 3200, and you know that's like intro level.
No, Denon makes really high end products.
Nah, I bet. Well, you were talking about them that one time that you were like,
So I know that they made really high end. They made like really high end DJ CD players, like not back in the day, but for people that use like actual.
They've been
hardware.
Making.
Bro, I used to have a Denon fucking tape deck back in the day.
Exactly.
What?
Yeah,
Denon's been making
like
speakers and
clear,
fucking shit
clear,
like that.
Like crystal clear audio. Like their audio is always good.
Denon's one of those brands back in the day you used to be able to get at like Pep Boys. Like Pep Boys. When you were like, if you didn't have the money to go to fucking Audio Express to get like a new stereo and you went to Pep Boys, Denon's. They used to have Denon fucking CD players and tape decks and shit back in the day, but... Yeah, no, hey, that fucking shit looked clean, bro. I like it how it has like the...
It's got little display
I feel like,
panels.
Are you getting
tight.
Used to that? Not having to look at the fucking screen instead of looking at them up top right there?
Honestly,
because I didn't see you looking. You kept looking at the fucking the thing and shit.
So you
like
have
the,
everything on your...
So, yeah, so it's basically got dual display screens. Like they're probably like little 4x4-inch little like
they're like four
monitors.
By three things like that.
Yeah,
and it's a
like
Serato controller.
It's a Serato controller, so it's got like the needle search, like touchpad, and then it's got you
all
know,
the B pads.
Yeah, you can control everything. It's got a sampler in it.
What's the mix of the fader like?
The fader's pretty nice, and you can upgrade it to a mini inno fader.
Oh, okay, so you can upgrade it to a battle scratch mixer.
Right. So yeah, I mean the only thing I've kind of noticed is that with controllers. You know, if you hit it to the left a little too hard, you know, it kind of cuts out the audio, and I think that's because of the cheap faders. But I know.
So if you get an inno fader, then you're gonna be in business.
Well, I'm definitely not scratching or anything right now, so I'm just I'm just working my way around those, working on those jog wheels. They're a little different.
With scratching, like you just got to get to the point where you don't have to be a battle scratcher. But just get nice with it a little bit,
yeah,
you know,
just mix it
a little bit in here. That you know what, YouTube goes a long way. I'm gonna tell you that
for sure.
I'm not gonna dry snitch on myself. I'm just gonna tell you, YouTube goes a long way, bro. You know, and it'll teach you what you need.
Any industry.
No, but specifically, like, it's not like back in the day where you had to search for DMC battle tapes. You know, that's the technique. Well, the number one, like, turntablism award is the DMCs.
Okay.
Fuck, I don't even know where I was going with this. I'm fucking high as
fuck. Lit. So lit.
Damn, I don't even know where I'm going with it.
Smoke weed every day.
You were talking about his controller. You're saying that YouTube is way, more user friendly.
Yeah. Oh, so yeah, so I'm saying you had to like locate those.
Back on the road. You get that off ramp real quick, but then he got right back on the freeway.
DJ Alva at the Hood Diner Podcast.
He went straight, and then he got right back on.
Yeah. You used to have to fucking really look for those type of tapes to learn the technique, and you'd have to stare at the this motherfucker's done.
Or even for records to use for
sure too, and the samples as well.
Exactly.
But like you used to have to really discover for like look for them, and now you type in a particular type of scratch, like one click flare, two click flare, three click flare. There's a video link that will you could have your turntables in front of you in a fucking TV.
Yeah.
And you can just fucking right there all day practicing, just fucking.
It's just like each individual tool in Photoshop and Illustrator. There's a video for that
shit. So many tutorials. YouTube is filled with so many great tutorials.
I talked about this the other day or one time on the podcast. And fucking, you know, a lot of people say that they're like, dude, if I knew now what I learned in fucking school and shit like that, I never would have gone to school and went just to YouTube, right? The difference is though, dog, like when you go to school, dog, like, school teaches you how to learn, not what you learn. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, it gives you the fundamentals of like...
Of thinking of, and processing. Of thinking,
yeah,
and
outside the box. Like I remember I asked my homie one time if he'd ever looked up any kind of tutorial about... Like, he was thinking about, like, something about his car. And I was like, why didn't you try to fix it yourself? He's like, I don't know how to fucking do that shit. And I'm like, why didn't you look it up on, like, YouTube and shit? And he's like, they show you that shit on there? I'm like, God damn, really? There's still people like you out there? What the fuck, bro?
The caveman invented fire?
Ooga booga YouTube. You know what I mean? Like, fucking, you don't know?
Absolutely.
No, bro, for real, dog. Like, it's getting to the point to where there's
so your homie was that brand new how long ago?
Just right now. Just like
what? In 2019?
This was my homie. This was my cousin.
Your cousin. Like,
I'm not even going to say his name because he's going to be all sad if I fucking put him on blast.
Don't put him on blast like that.
Regardless.
Jeez Louise. You don't know about no YouTube.
Don't know about no YouTube, bro. Thankfully, he's probably like
my kid on YouTube knows right now. YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
She's on YouTube. Six on Friday, dog.
Hey, any little kid with an iPad knows what YouTube is, definitely. Fuck
kids
yeah.
Be the best at using iPads. Like,
you got any games on your phone?
Oh, yeah, that's God. What my little kid.
Well, sure don't.
That shit.
Sure don't. What's your fucking little...
Can I watch YouTube on your phone then?
Yeah. Nope. You got Netflix?
I'm out of internet.
What's the internet? What's the code?
What's your password?
What's the password? Hey, man, before we go any further, dog, let me knock out the fucking sponsorship shit on this bitch real quick.
Sponsorship shit.
Sponsorship shit, bro. Dude wipes. Dude wipes are a flushable wipe for at-home and on-the-go situations. Go to dudeproducts.com, use code HOOD, and get 15% off your order.
Dude wipes keeps that ass clean.
I'm all, let me just finish. Let me just wait till you're done.
Hashtag no mud butt.
Hashtag no mud butt. Official clothing. Official clothing is a streetwear brand rooted in hip-hop and pop culture, producing runs of quality shirts, hats, and accessories. Go to official.com. It's OHFISHL.com. Use code HOOD and get 25% off your whole order. Free shipping over $50. Official clothing, baby. Live by your own rules.
Yeah!
You got to come up with your own kind of reason.
Like that,
okay?
That.
Make sure you do that. Get company with your shit, bro. The more fucking just legit it sounds. Okay.
I feel you.
Empire Rolling, the makers of Benny's, created with the connoisseur in mind. Benny's are a high-end rolling paper created from all natural ingredients, offering a clean, tobacco-free alternative to blunt-like smoke sessions. Click the affiliate link in the description. Go to empirerolling.com, use code HOOD, and get 10% off that order. The other day, the homie was like, dude, them fucking papers are kind of pricey. I'm like, well, you know, that's a high-end rolling paper.
You pay for quality.
You pay for that quality, you know what I'm saying? You want to have that.
Apparently, you can't get them in town, can't right?
From what I've checked, man, or from what I've heard, you know what I'm saying? But watch, you know, if anybody listens, they're going to be like, okay, get the Bennies.
But right now,
if you want to get some of them shits, you know, holler at your boy. I'll sell you some of them shits. Go to empirerolling.com. Use code HOOD. Get 10% off your order. That's Empire Rolling, the official rolling paper of the Hood Diner Podcast.
Yeah!
Also want to give a shout out to the Inner Circle Podcast Network. Go to innercirclepn.com and follow all the motherfucking homies right there. HT Nas, Sam PC, Shit Happens When You Party Naked, Any Pod, The Plunge, Failing Hollywood, and of course, the Diner. We roll with some homies, dog. I'm telling you, dog. You build, bro.
Let's build on.
I roll with some homies too.
I've told you. We're gonna talk about that. I've told you, but we linked up with that. I always mention this shit, but it's true, man. When we linked up with them and we just started, like, you know, pushing for each other and shit like that, dude. We started getting fans from all across the U.S. and shit, dog. And, like, we have more likes and retweets from people we've never met before than we do from, like, people here and shit. You know what I'm saying? So you never fucking believe fully in that whole shit where if you can't make it in your own city, people say you can't make it. That's bullshit, dog. You know what I'm saying? We in that age of the internet, man. You just gotta get Tucson's shit out
fickle
there.
As fuck.
People, you get it to the right people and your shit is dope, bro. People will buy that shit, dog. Like, I just got an order for a fucking hat from somebody in Miami. I don't know anybody in Miami, but they bought a fucking hat. You know what I'm saying? So nice. I'm like, all right, I'm send that shit out right now. So, yeah, nice. Man. Shout out to the Inner Circle Podcast Network, man. Roach Boyz. And, yeah. So, I'm going to get into a couple of these news topics real quick before we go into the questions and shit. Okay, news. You alright over there, dog?
I'm fucking lit, bro.
I feel that.
You know what I'm talking about?
All right. What you got over there, dude?
I got some cashews. You
cashew?
Like
no, you're good, bro. Go ahead.
No, I'm good, bro. Thank you.
Just try not to fucking right into the mic. I mean, you can if you want, but it's kind of people don't.
Yeah,
like
bro.
That.
Do you? Do what you? Got you all right.
Okay, so in the
I'm
news,
I'm gonna fuck our listeners. I'm just kidding.
In the news, I saw today. This just passed, man. Congress just passed a bill making animal cruelty a federal felony. Fuck yeah, I'm all for that. You know what I'm saying? And we talked about that last week. We were talking about the dude that killed the dog, or somebody that killed the fucking dog. They got more years than that homegirl that went into the dude's house and shot him. She only got 10 years, but that dude got 45 for killing a dog. You know what I'm saying? It's a totally different concept, but this is just animal cruelty.
So I can discipline my daughter, but I can't discipline my animal.
To classify as animal cruelty, bro, you got to do some serious shit.
Right.
Like fucking, like basically damn near kill the animal or just like brutally do some shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, harm. Wouldn't it be?
I feel like you have to have just reason if you're gonna for what fucking you're doing. Not like not
discipline your kid.
Animal cruelty is just beating it for no reason.
Well, yeah.
Or something like that. You know, if you're punishing it for doing something like that, you know, you're trying to teach it something. That's what you're doing with that. But the people that are getting charged for that, I bet you I feel like they're physically just putting them in danger.
Just taking it to another level.
For their
another
own
level,
enjoyment.
Yeah, it's
or,
more
know,
than
they're
discipline.
Getting something out of
it's
it.
Not discipline. That's cruelty.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So shout out to them for passing that shit. Okay.
Well, at the end of the day, I'm not going to sock my dog in his fucking face.
For right? sure.
You know what I'm saying? That's not discipline.
Yeah, exactly.
It's at the end of the day, though, like if someone's like, what's it called, like in self-defense, like that's also going to be a factor too.
Well, yeah, it's obviously it's going to be situation to situation. That's cruelty. Yeah, if that dog was fucking biting you, you had every right to fucking fuck that dog up. I'm kicking him in the nuts. I'm doing whatever the fuck to get that dog off me. Yeah, dude, dogs will fuck you up, man, for real.
Bro, police have dogs.
Yeah.
Police will launch a dog before they come after you.
Right. Hey, did you hear that fucking Joe Rogan got Edward Snowden on his latest podcast?
You know what's crazy is that I was finishing work today and I was listening to it.
You know who that is, right?
That's the dude.
The whistleblower.
WikiLeaks motherfucker and shit. WikiLeaks.
Yeah.
These are fucking fire, bro.
WikiLeaks. Anyways, so yeah, dude, he got him on there. So I checked out a snippet of it on YouTube, but I found one that said how the government is watching you through your phone. He does a lot of explaining on how that works and shit like that, dude. But yeah, dude, it was crazy. It's like he didn't get him in the spot. It was obviously like some over-the-air type shit. But still, dude, the fact that he got Rogan on there, dude.
It's just whack that the government's looking at me when I'm fucking yanking my dick.
Right?
Because you know when you're on Pornhub, they're definitely recording you.
It's called put a piece of tape on the
camera. Yo, you're just fucking beating off on your phone and you're just fucking government's like this, bro, just fucking staring at you.
I'm pretty sure I see the episode of Black Mirror on that.
Where it showed from that angle and shit?
Well, yeah, it was showing like something like that happened. You know the show Black Mirror, right?
I've seen the first three episodes.
Okay, yeah. So Black Mirror, if you don't know, it's a show that's it's based on this like crazy concepts and they take it to a whole new level. Every episode is different.
It's like a new Twilight Zone.
There you go. That's a good explanation right there. New Twilight Zone.
And so there's an episode. I'm pretty sure there's an episode, and you know, or it might be in a similar show like that I've seen it, but it shows like that where it's like it got like a whole recording of him. you know, like it's got him, like it recorded it through his webcam, you know, he's just beating off and it just got it through his webcam and use it against him type shit like that.
Dude, you know what? And that's, I've always had that idea in the back of my mind, dog. Have you ever heard of like the whole fucking Mark of the Beast shit? Like the day where it comes where there's no longer going to be currencies and you're going to have to get like a fucking chip in order to like spend money. And like this way, they'll always know where the fuck you are, your money, everything's linked to this fucking chip. It's like, I think it's based off a book called like 1984 or some shit like
you
that.
You already got that. They already got a chip card.
Okay.
Like pretty much everywhere. Like if you don't have cash, which in like some places, I don't take bills over $20. Well, if you only got $100, you're using your ATM card. Like you got, you know, you're on the road or something like that. Yeah. You know, say you're on the run or something like that. You're linked. You got
the biggest one is the phone. Like that's your GPS to the world.
Saying, you know,
shit.
Like as far as money system, you know, like that's the thing. Like if you got all your funds in the bank on that one card, every time you use that card, they know exactly where you're at.
Right.
So beside a phone, you could live without a phone. But you got to spend money and things like that.
The whole thing was based around like, you know, getting chipped and shit. And it's like
crazy.
It's like the type of thing where it's like the new world order. And it's going to come down to like, they're going to approach you and be like, you know, are you going to fucking do this? Right. And a lot of people are going to willingly do it because they're not going to want to go against the machine. Right. But the people that are going to be like, nah, fuck that. You know what I'm saying? They're going to have all that shit gathered on you. And so they're going to be like, look, dog, like, I don't want to have to show your wife the 150,000 times you beat it off to fucking Pornhub and this and that. We have all those videos.
My wife's going to know that I'm beating off.
All the shit that you fucking looked up, all the fucked up shit doing.
No, all the sex tapes you made
that wasn't with her, blah, blah, blah.
No,
all
no.
That shit.
I mean, once you get to a point where you're with a wife, all else is forgiven prior to that point.
I'm just saying, like, they're going
to
use all your dirt.
Right.
They're going to use all your dirt against you.
To
get you to be the mark of the beast.
I guess I'm just living.
You say I do, you're like, okay, I forgive you from everything in the past. You have to, right?
They're like, all your student loans are taken care of.
It's like a baptism.
All your debt is taken care of. You just have to fucking get this chip. And that's what they call it. They call it like the mark of the beast. It's like getting branded and shit. Like, psst, motherfucker, you belong to this fucking new world order.
I'm just waiting for the dystopian society, like fucking.
To rise up.
Futuristic movies and shit. Like, it's.
You don't think that fucking is already like an uneven battle?
Bro, you see the fucking homeless population, even in Tucson.
Man, but they're not, what are they going to do?
If
it goes mark
of
the beast and everybody's like an uprising, they don't have no guns.
There's going to be more of that, though. There's going to be more homeless.
Oh, there's going to be a lot of homeless people.
Yeah, like.
They're not going to be, though. They're not going to give you a choice. They're going to be like, look, dude, like. Or yeah, I guess. Yeah, you're going to go homeless.
You
won't have any money.
I don't even trip on that shit.
Because
you know
what,
bro?
The new world order doesn't use cash or credit or anything. It uses the fucking microbes that run through your fucking veins and shit like that, dude. And like the only way to live is to get this shit injected. Now, if you're going to get it, you're going to get it. Cool. You're a part of us. But if you don't get it, we're going to use all the bad shit you did against you. And if that's not enough, then fucking yeah, dude. They'll probably
just set you up.
You're
talking about what if, man?
I'm talking about what if, like that day, if that day ever comes, man. You know,
are you gonna fucking take the green pill or the blue pill or the red pill? What are you gonna
do? I don't know, dude. But you know, there is a solution to all that fucking shit you were talking about, and it's called a piece of tape.
Oh, I don't give a fuck if they're watching me beat off.
A piece of tape over.
I'm a nasty motherfucker. I like watching people do them themselves. You know, like women, like, you know, going to town on themselves. That's cool. You know,
he's like, I'm gonna sit back like this.
Hey,
like,
I want to get that new apple with the extra wide angle.
That's that deep strip club just lurk.
Hey, bro, that's primal fucking energy right there. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck yeah, dog. But yeah, man, that shit's fucking crazy.
I don't even trip on it. I don't even care.
Also, dog, check this out. Last thing I got for the news, and it was some funny shit. Is there was a rally, Trump rally earlier and shit, and he was out there talking and shit, and he was talking about the wall, and he started mentioning states. He's like, we got to build this wall. We're building it in New Mexico. It's big. It's lovely. We're building it in Colorado. It's big. It's lovely. We're building one in Texas. It's big. It's lovely and shit. And everybody was just like, yay. But everybody on Twitter was like, did that motherfucker just say Colorado?
Colorado.
Like, there's fucking memes of, like, the United States and this big red state. And it's, like, way the fuck, like, 100,
yeah,
dog, 200 and some
like
miles from the
there,
fucking
bro,
thing.
Like,
he's wrong. He obviously probably confused Colorado for Arizona, I guess. I mean, you know, all us Mexicans that's look alike to him, you know. But fucking anyways.
Lil Wedda fucking recorded it with a fucking filter on Instagram. And he had like the black demon eyes in the face. It was like a green.
I think I saw that.
It was fucking wild. I'm like, I messaged her. I'm like, this is the scariest shit I've ever seen in my life. She goes, LOL. She goes, it's even scarier without the filter.
Boom. Fuck yeah, dude. See, she knows, dude. But yeah, dude, dumb fuck said Colorado. So yeah, I had to do that. I don't have any music news this week. Did you have any music news for this week? Anything new in the music business?
I'm honestly still tripping on that Tekashi deal.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm still dumbfounded.
Yeah, I think I seen some more shit to that, too. Like, really? That he's supposed to get a show. What's going on with a show. Okay, so you know how he was
currently I'm at the point where he's snitching on everybody, but he's also saying that he doesn't want to take the
security. The yeah, he doesn't want to do witness protection.
He wants to still rap.
So he's he's gonna have to have like the ultimate amount of fucking security. Shit because
right. He said he would get the ultimate security
during
right?
all this
he said
shit.
That.
Yeah, yeah.
He'd get the best security he could get or whatever.
I think right after that is when they announced that he. Got a $10 million deal through some rap label. So he's already going to have new music coming out of shit.
I bet.
And the last thing I heard
he's
is
a
that
name now. He's a household name. Like grandmas know about Tekashi now.
Last thing I heard is that there's probably going to be a show that goes along
with what if
with
it was all
shit.
A big gimmick?
Yeah, that movie. I seen that.
Something like that, dude. Yeah. So think about that. Like if there's going to be a show or anything like that, that they are going to, not only are they taking on the risk of being around him, they're going to have to fucking also have plenty of extra security.
Wait,
you know
wait,
what I'm
wait,
saying?
Wait,
for
wait,
all
wait.
Their people and shit.
What if that dude's like a whole industry plant?
Because right?
Look at the way he's the world over. You know what I mean? They took down this, ATF probably took down this major gang organization in New York. They used Tekashi as an informant.
As a platform, yeah.
He got out and they're like, they built him up. He built his whole brand up. Now everybody knows Tekashi.
But we need you to go to the extreme. You need to get 6'9"s on your face.
See, I'd be 60. I'd be Tekashi 68. I owe you one.
Okay, there you go.
Talking about
non pussy licking motherfucker.
Yeah. What I'm talking about?
No, 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 no. Te gusta la la la.
Hey,
he said, hey.
She's a special lady, maybe. You know
okay.
what I'm saying?
Okay, take notes, lady.
Like if you're staying the night at the house,
if
then
you're
yeah.
a one night stand, he ain't doing it.
Well, it didn't even have to be not the one night stand aspect. It's just like if you're not staying the night at the house, I'm not doing that to you.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying? Like if I'm not gonna wake you up in the morning and stab you before you leave.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not eating that the night before. You know what I'm saying? Like it just ain't happening.
You've been out all night sweating and fucking.
Even then,
and
like
it
gets me
shit.
In the right mood. Hey, you know.
Hey,
you know what
I'm saying? Hey. He said, hey, ladies. He said, hey,
lick the night off of you. Okay, fuck yeah.
When it's Mr. Nasty time, all bets are off. You know
Mr.
what I'm saying?
Mr. Nasty time. Okay,
That's your nickname? It'd be Mr. Nasty?
No.
What would you call yourself?
He's Freaky Cheeky, bro.
Freaky Cheeky?
I even thought about changing my DJ name to that.
Freaky Cheeky? Okay.
Because Cheeky's my nickname, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And
why'd they call you Cheeky?
You know, your boy had the cheeks when
did
he was
you,
a
little
kid. Did
you, little fucking mouse-cateer looking motherfucker?
Yeah, but.
Or what do they call chipmunks?
You know.
Little chipmunk cheeks.
But, yeah, I even thought about changing it to that, but I'm like, nah, I've been DJ Century for so long that...
What was Century?
I just thought it was a dope name, and I looked on, like, I was early on the internet, typed in DJ Century in, like, MySpace and fucking Yahoo Search and, like, just different avenues, and nothing came up, so I was like, fuck, I'm gonna rock with it.
I feel you.
He was quick to it, but he wasn't fast enough to it, because he has DJ _ Century.
Right.
There's a DJ at DJ Century's out there somewhere. You know what I mean? He got the full fucking thing. He got the no underscore.
At least you didn't have to get like DJ Century like 5
underscore
5-2.
Right.
Hey, dude, hey. Don't fuck now. You just clowned on me, dog.
No.
Cause my shit is casual 5-2-0.
No,
but I'm gonna tell
you
what.
But
let me tell you something. I've told this fool. If there's a way to go back in Google search fucking history and see who's the first one to make like your name with a 520 behind it, I shit you not if I'm not one of the first ones, bro. For real, dog. Because like I did a little rebranding, bro. Like when I used to rap back in the day, I was called Trouble One. Okay. TROUBLE1. But then when I wanted to switch it, I was like, dude, okay, trying to change it up. Something that goes with my lifestyle, the way I'm fucking chilling. You know what I'm saying? I'm a chill dude. I'm a laid back motherfucker. I'm fucking casual. You know what I'm saying? But then the way I liked it was the fact that I put like a lowercase K and a big AZ and then UAL. You know what I'm saying? So it was more a play on the letters and shit.
Yes, sir.
But there is a group in Atlanta called Casual, and they spell it like that. They're like an R&B group. There's four dudes and shit. So they had that. They had all the at Casuals. So I was fucking second to use it too. You know what I'm saying? So I probably could have gone Casual underscore or fucking Casual AZ, but I fucking, at the time when I was rapping at that time, dog, it was all about fucking being like the 520 love and fucking 520 this. So, you know, that's why I put 520. And there's fucking hundreds of us that have that 520 shit, dude.
I'm not really tripping on the underscore because it spaces out the length.
I get that. You know what I'm saying? I get that. Yeah. For a DJ thing, I mean, because I've seen where they do, you know, the barber ones and shit like that. Like, it'd be the name, underscore, the, underscore, barber. So, like, you know, I get it. It's like a play on the letters and shit like that.
And it's real short, too.
Has yours got an underscore between the Alva
and the DJ? No, see, I did mine, and I wish I could change it now, but I'm kind of already too in-depth with it. Yeah. But I did DJ at Young Alva. I was going by Young Alva because I was just DJing and, like, just being, like, 18, DJing, just, like...
How old are you now?
I'm 24 right now. 24?
How old are you, bro? 17. Oh, shit.
God damn.
Okay. I'm on the clock and shit. I'm like, nah, it's cool. Nah, dude, that's dope. Okay, so you told me.
He graduated early.
Okay.
Yeah, so he's already done.
And you said that he does your the designs for you?
Yeah, so we work on everything together.
Tell us about the brand, dog.
So my brand is called Poison Boyz. You can find us at Poison Boyz Apparel on Instagram. And
you just launched a website too, right?
We just launched a website.
What's the website address?
The website is just poisonboyz.com. So that's P-O-I-S-O-N.
You were able to get it just like that? That's good.
So the thing about Poison Boyz is it's we spelled the boys with a Z instead of an S. So casual. We were able to get he said casual.
Well, shout out to casual.
He said so we spelled it with a Z, so we were able to get that name. So it's out, it's Poison Boyz, so it's poisonboyz.com.
Okay.
And so we just launched our website October 1st. And we've been
we also launched our first line.
Our first real like anything like as far as branding, doing everything to really build up clientele and a real fan base other than just in Tucson, you know, to reach out to other markets. The internet's a huge, vast place.
Yep.
And I feel like there's a lot of dope brands in Arizona and Tucson, other places, you know, and traveling the Southwest and doing shows in other places. You know, I've seen super dope merch, super dope cool things, you know, things that you just don't find because people don't, you know, have websites or things like that. So I'll try to take it in a whole different direction this time, you know, and just put a lot more professionalism into it. So right now we're currently working on, you know, getting make sure that we got like professional pictures out,
right?
You know, doing professional shoots and everything like that. So so we got pictures on the way, but everything's for sale. Where, you know, we've really been moving the clothing well. So definitely, yeah.
This dude does your hats, right?
Yes, sir.
I actually did the one they're wearing right now.
Both of them. You did the one I'm wearing too.
Yeah, well.
Are you doing the one you're wearing?
I did the one I'm wearing.
Well, what do you know?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Shout out. But this Cobra hat goes hard. Like, yo, I'm like.
Shout out New Stitch.
I hate like. Well, thank you. I just let the work do the talking, period.
Fucking ain't right.
You know what I'm saying?
He did actually weigh more. So he did three hats for us, a backpack, two different kinds of accessory bags. Yeah, we got some cool things.
You're happy with the way everything came out?
Yeah, everything is dope. Everybody's super excited. All the embroiders, like, everybody's dope. That chain design, really selling. Everybody likes those
hats. Did you understand what I said with the detail?
Yeah, definitely. You know, everything came out great. You know, shout out. We were talking about that the other day. Shout out Robert fucking Century on everything.
Shit, it can be too complex to be vectored.
And it was. And it was. But my thing is this. How am I going to let the homie... Like, how am I going to do the homie dirty like that? Like, I had to fucking go in outside the box. So it was like literally sewing one segment, it would do a line, sew the next segment, and then it would fucking do a line, and it would do it would like it was weaving the fucking segments together like a chain link fence. And it was tedious just thinking about it because you got to think about how it would look before it's done, you know?
Right.
You want that woven effect. And I think I achieved it.
When woven. You get that whoa.
Well, because they're twisted, the chain links. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get you.
Like you said, us is actually got to make it look like a chain link.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That whole fucking...
That way you got to twist
the... So that's exactly what I was telling Cash the other day when we were at the show. I was telling him, you know, there's, you know, been times that, you know, there's people... When I was comparing prices, you know, as doing this as a business, we also do screen printing, you know, as another side business. I also do screen printing on the side.
Mm.
And, we're talking about just doing orders and you know, people sending us artwork that, you know, is not very good artwork, you know, and trying to do our best with it, because you don't want to let that clientele down, you know, or send them back, you know, because, you know, bigger companies like that, you know, they won't take your artwork. They'll just tell you, you know, I can't.
Well, no, they have departments where they'll fucking charge you a fee to fix it.
Exactly, yeah.
So much,
but yeah, you know that, and that's what I'm saying. You know, shout out Century. You know, he always works with us, does everything. You know, because we try to make like really high end work as far as artwork and super detailed. And sometimes it's a little hard for embroidery, but
yeah.
Century always kills it. We're always, you know, super excited every time we pick that. Every time we got to roll up, we got to roll up to pick up those hats. Super stoked. We both hop in the car, just pumped.
Yep.
So
trust me, man.
Definitely.
We've been doing business for a minute.
But yeah, so Century plays a big role on my team. But yeah, so we're going back.
My thing was like, I fuck with you on the regular, you know what I'm saying? So like, I couldn't like half step it at all. Like my thing is, I can't guarantee when someone brings their garment in. Like if I fuck up a hat, I didn't mean to do it. Something happens sometimes.
Right.
There's something that'll like the thread will get pulled and I have to like rip the fucking garment off, and sometimes it'll leave a hole that's not fixable. It'll pop off and it'll sew to the point where it's just, there's too much stitches to unravel to where it's just
right.
gone. But I've just tried to slow it down a little bit. When you have a machine that can go 1,000 rotations per minute, why run your car at 100 miles an hour every single day?
Right.
It's not going to last you very long. Right. That's what the technician told me. So I run it about 660. This is about as fast as I go.
Game.
It's tighter. Right. The stitches look tighter, you know. I mean,
yeah, and I'm sure it took some time to figure. I mean, well, dude, I've
been getting. He probably doesn't have as many slips because it's just, you know, going through it, and it's you know, it's not as like dun 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 dun. You know, it's just like dun 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 dun.
I've been getting hats from him for like 5 years, dog. Right, mad dun. I've been getting hats from him for like, 5 years now, and I've noticed the difference, man. Like how much fucking better and cleaner they look now, dog. Fucking. It's good shit, bro.
You know, you got to be a master at your craft, you know?
Fuck yeah. All right, man. Let's slide into movies and TV.
You see the fucking Star Wars fucking trailer?
I have not seen the Star Wars. We're talking about
Poison Boyz real quick.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Before we move down to the segment, I'll just let my little homie introduce himself. Tell him a little bit about himself as we introduce the rest of the team. Robert's the other half of the team, DJ fucking Century.
I'm Jay. I do all the designs and shit. Yeah, we've been working for a long time. We've been doing this for about 4 years now. I started printing shirts and stuff when I was in, you know, like 7th grade, I think.
Okay.
So I started moving stuff when I was in middle school, and, you know, I really got the hang of it. And I started out with just like transferring like just images onto shirts and stuff and selling them. And I had this little brand called Roman Royalty. It was just like a double R. Like, it was pretty cool. But, you know, people saw the hyping and how fast I got it moving. So I had a bunch of people. I made like $500 in a month for a 7th grader. You know, that's a lot.
Yeah, right.
So, it encourages you to, if you see that kind of money when you're that young, you know, it just keeps encouraging you to do it more. So, I kind of moved my way throughout high school, and I didn't really want to be there. I wanted just to do my own thing,
So that's what you meant when he said you graduated early?
Yeah, yeah. By the time I decided that I wanted to graduate early, I had already had all this stuff established and stuff. So I was ready to get out of school and just start doing it. And so, you know, like I said, once you start seeing that money come in and you see that, you see like the progression that it takes, okay. Like, and you know, to have only one person that's working with you is pretty hard, you know, especially coming up for a brand and stuff.
Yeah.
It's really, really hard. So, yeah. Cause like a lot of people I look up to they're doing it with teams and they've been moving with teams and stuff. But yeah, it's really hard to do with two people, but I'm glad that we got this far. It's crazy that we got this far.
It's the best way to learn, I think, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like, to me, my main mission has always been to cut out as many middlemen as possible. You know what I'm saying? I'm definitely not going to learn to embroider, so this is my main dude. You know what I'm saying? But I've made my own shirts. Mm. I've made my own, like, beanies. I make all the bracelets and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a certain level of pride that comes with when you know how every aspect of how it's done and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And so, you know, it's cool, and keep up the work with that, because then eventually, you know what I'm saying, when the success definitely comes to the point to where you will need a team, Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because you can't do it all, especially when, you know, when the amounts of shit that you got to produce gets higher, then you'll definitely like develop into a team. I've always wanted to get to that point, but I've never put 100% into it because it's always been like a side hustle for me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? My main shit is all my graphics and all that shit. You know what I mean? But, you know,
I got into that too. Yeah, I got in. That's how I started like doing all like the designs and stuff. Was
good with like Illustrator and Photoshop.
Yeah,
and shit?
Yeah. So I began in that. My dad, you know, has a degree in that, so he's taught me a lot, and like he's always, you know, trying to push me to keep doing that, you know, and stuff, and keep, you know, not to go to school for it, but just to you know, learn, like you said, like off of YouTube.
Yeah, like what we were talking about earlier. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
like anything you can, especially with that type of stuff, like you can make a whole living off of just learning what you got on YouTube, buying a Mac, and then putting your designs out there.
I like that, man. I like that there's a lot of people out there that are becoming entrepreneurs and, you know, working from home and doing what they got to do to get by, you know what I'm saying? But it's tough. It's tough, man. It's a long process, but, you know, you guys just keep it up, man. Definitely, dog. What's the name of that? What's on the website one more time?
It's poisonboyz.com, PoisonBoyz.com.
Boom.
Huh? My Instagram's, I got at HolyGrxil, Holy Grail. I go by Holy Grail too. Okay. And Dre. All right. But yeah, that's my Instagram.
Dope. Hell yeah.
You gonna roll up that round two or what?
Let's get it.
Get it in. All right, let me go. Let's switch into movies and TV real quick.
And here we go.
Are you the Keymaster?
Laugh it up, fuzzball.
We came, we saw, we kicked it down.
This baby hits 88 miles per hour. They're gonna see some serious shit.
Okay, what did you say about
Star Wars fucking trailer?
Okay, it's good.
Yeah. I mean, I'm amped now.
Okay, this is what I heard.
It was on Monday Night Football.
Like, we can buzz in right here, like, oh, let's play this really quick.
Bro, we're working on that soon.
All that. But what I read today that was actually kind of crazy is it says that this one is going to be the longest Star Wars that they've ever put out.
239?
235 is what it's at. Like, that's no end game, but still, that's a long time. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, 235. And
you know what I was getting into?
What?
Fucking Top Boys.
I started watching that too.
Yeah,
Top Boy,
that shit's hard. It's on Netflix.
Oh, that's
Top.
That
it's like them Top Boy, bro.
English gangsters and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Damn. And that blunt and net.
Yeah.
Or that you can fucking use one of
them papers too, if you want.
That shit was.
You were like, how? You were like, how do them shits roll? Exactly. You were like, how do them shits taste?
Yeah. You want all of these? Yeah,
I'll do it. I'll even replace your two that you were gonna take home with you. All right.
Yeah, but that show's pretty tight. Like, they come up on
that's cool.
They come up on work and they call it food. Uh-huh. And it's weird because they don't have guns in the UK. You know what I'm saying? Like, obviously gangsters got guns and shit, but like guns isn't a thing every day in the United Kingdom. Yeah.
Guns are like expensive and hard to come.
Yeah, like you're a fucking badass if you got your gunplay. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So seeing them murk each other in the streets and that, it was like pretty graphic, you know?
So they're over there murking people with knives and things like that?
Yeah, like knives, you see them scrapping and shit.
You see the cops where they got them billy clubs and shit.
Like, a lot of those like those movies that happen like in the UK and stuff, like they always show like everybody scraps. Like everybody's down to scrap.
Oh, yeah.
No one has guns. Over, like people over here to shoot people.
What was the one about the dudes that were fucking like soccer fans? It's kind of called something like that. What do they call soccer fans over
Hooligans.
There? Hooligans. Hooligans. Have you seen that movie? You ever seen the movie Hooligans? Have you ever seen the movie Hooligans?
Nah.
Dude, what talk about? That's a dope. Dude, just like a set of homies, like a brother, and they have homies, and they're like their own little clique from a certain set over there in England and shit. But they're also like, they also love like their soccer. So they're soccer hooligans and shit like that. They love the soccer. But they like just scrap like a bunch of times in that fucking movie. It's good, dog.
They're but called that's the firms. Name of
it. It's called Hooligans, bro.
They're called firms.
Firms.
They're like
avid
like hooligans that are to a particular club, Liverpool.
So, who the fuck are you?
Manchester United.
I'm from Manchester.
Yeah, Everton. All there's like I follow Premier League. I used to play FIFA a lot, but it's just this year sucks.
Yeah. Do they have fights in the streets and that?
No.
Okay,
not
then it's not real.
Oh, it's a simulation, man. But it's dope. Scoring a fucking goal in that game is awesome. Hey, yo, shout out to my daughter, bro. She scored a goal last weekend.
You talked about that on the last
time. No, she scored another goal. One? Yeah.
Did you get this one on film?
No.
Okay, that's cool.
No. It's up here, though.
Talked about,
it's up here.
I gave him shit for not having it. I was like, well, if you stay ready, you ain't got to get ready. I was like, you should have just had the phone, like, with the video thing on, just chilling right there. And then, honestly, man, like, the way these phones are set up now, dude, you a second you can be in video mode.
No, I know, I know.
You know, from that little but fucking thing in the corner right there, just...
She kicked it from far. And it fucking rolled in. I'm like, oh shit. Damn.
Nice.
I told her, I said, you need a, you need a, she said, I want to do this, dad. She started dabbing.
The dab, dude.
I'm like, no, 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 no. I said, you know what you need to do, baby? You need to get the fucking arrow out of your back like this. And you need to pull back the bow and you need to shoot it. That's what I want to teach her to do to celebration.
What is that from?
Nice.
Just, that's just a soccer celebration.
That shit. Okay.
Who does that? Who does that you see do that?
It wasn't like Messi or anybody. It was just some like a replay.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, he pulls it out and he just shoots it like that.
Kill shot.
Yeah.
Right. Or like that. You know that shit that they do like when they have those Viking funerals and they put someone in the river.
Yeah.
And they
go
and then there's a
dude that's got to hit it from way the fuck out there and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like that fucking pose.
I forgot what I watched. It was Game of Thrones. He's like, give me that damn thing. And he gets it and he shoots it.
That was sad. He couldn't do it and shit. He's like, give it to me. You
the fucking
shot it and then like gave it to him and walked back. Didn't even wait for it to land. He's like, flunk, and then fucking just hands him the shit. Goes back, stands, and then it just
falls right where he
fires right up, bro.
And he's holding the fucking bow, and he looks like an asshole.
Yeah. Have any of you guys seen The Joker yet?
No.
Have you seen The Joker movie?
I want to go see it this Friday.
You're fucking up, dog. You were fucking up right now.
I just realized that it's Joaquin Phoenix that plays The Joker.
Dog.
Really? And I'm honestly, I really like torn because I seen this movie called I Am Joaquin Phoenix. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
Yeah, he's a rapper.
It's not even just that, but it's like this fool's just on drugs and it's like about his life and it's crazy.
Oh, isn't it called I'm Still Here?
Or or whichever.
But it's about Joaquin Phoenix?
It's about Joaquin Phoenix.
It's wild.
Is it really?
It's wild. Like,
okay.
It's
but
wild.
Is somebody else playing Joaquin
Phoenix? No, it's him. Documenting his life.
Documentary his life. It's crazy.
I have not seen it. Like, he does
some crazy party, bro.
Okay, fuck yeah. Why would not? I mean, think about it. Dude, think about his name. And then his brother was River Phoenix, man. They were the sons of hippies.
His brother died at what's it called?
At the Comedy Store, right?
No, Viper Room.
Oh, the Viper Room.
Yeah. Whose club was that? Somebody's
Johnny Depp.
No. It was Dave Faustino, which was Bud Bundy, and somebody else. They both owned it and shit. I don't know.
But it was like known as Johnny Depp's club. I think you're right. I heard something like that.
Probably. I don't know. But I know at the time, Bud Bundy was a co-owner and shit. I remember seeing that shit. But yeah, Doug, fucking.
That's crazy, though. Yeah.
But it's a good fucking movie, though, bro. Make sure you see it in the theater, bro.
I'm definitely going to go see it.
With that fucking sound.
How did he play the Joker? Because honestly, Heath Ledger killed it in The Dark Knight. Killed it.
I'm going to say this. Going into this movie, not expecting the kabooms and the big flashes.
This isn't a fucking your typical comic.
Okay.
This is like not Avengers.
This is like a Scorsese film, bro. This is like true drama shit. It's good. It's good shit. You're going to leave
there
feeling.
It's like The Dark Knight because The Dark Knight was good drama. I thought it was good.
No,
because
Dark Knight had fucking the Batmobile and shit.
There was still kabooms and fucking, you know. Insane.
Like, it had special
get
effects.
Get over here and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
but I thought it was, I thought it got played pretty good. And Heath Ledger was pretty nasty in that one, too.
I just can't see anybody fucking with Joaquin Phoenix's performance ever.
Really?
Ever.
It's like that?
And I came up on the animated series. I'm a big fucking Mark Hamill, who is Luke Skywalker.
Right.
He does the voice in the animated series. I'm a big... That's like my favorite Joker, because he's funny. He's still diabolical, but he was like too nice because he was meant for daytime television.
Right.
So when you see that kind of era Joker being played, but like... Oh, dude, I just don't even want to fuck it up for you because that's how good
it
is.
You see what it is that pushes him over the edge, bro.
I feel it.
It's like
you
see the transition. It's the origin story, dude. It's so good, bro.
And I could also see like Joaquin Phoenix. Like I saw like articles coming out once I found out that it was Joaquin Phoenix. Like articles about like what an asshole he was to work with and about how crazy it was like to work with him.
But have you seen the way he looks? How skinny he got?
Yeah, crazy.
So.
That's what I'm saying. In that other movie, I'm Still Here, whatever it's called. Like, he plays a totally different role, and his life is crazy. Like, this is after River Phoenix died and everything, so his life is crazy, like super crazy. Like, he just seems like he's on drugs, like he's just mad depressed.
I mean, dude, he took it there to put himself in the space that it took to bring that fucking character to life.
Didn't fucking Diddy fucking like, nah, man, this ain't it. In that movie?
Yeah. Yeah, he did some shit like that. I saw Joaquin shits on another man's face, like in his sleep, like in a hotel room. They're like on tour and he just like wakes up and Joaquin just is just shitting in his face.
Okay.
Like I'm telling you, it's like it's some crazy shit. Like it's wild. It's like a documentary, like really documentary how crazy his life is.
Bro, like you got that much money, it's like nothing's a no to you.
Yeah, like
nothing's no.
Okay.
You know, that's wild.
You don't live by no law.
What about Zombieland 2?
I'm going to go check that out tomorrow.
Okay, I saw it.
Liked it?
It's good.
Good, good.
It's good.
It's good.
It's definitely, it's good.
It's worth watching in the theater. Better than the
first. I don't want to say I don't think it's better than the first, but it's good.
Well, it's hard to be better than the first.
Yeah, a lot of times it is hard to be better.
Like if they made Old School 2. It wouldn't work.
Like think about it like now. Like maybe if they made like Old School 2 back then, like maybe like 2-3 years after.
Yeah, but Zombieland did come out like almost 10 years ago, probably. Yeah, it's like
a grip ago, dude. But like they're troopers. You can see them all. They've all aged. Like a motherfucker.
I don't know about the second one. It was okay. Good. It was okay.
See, and that's my thing is I went in there for entertainment.
Yeah.
That's how I approach these comedic movies. Because if you're gonna nitpick,
you're right.
It's just whack.
Yeah.
Although, okay, we were talking about nitpick, dude. This is the one beef I have. I finally watched El Camino. Okay. Have you guys seen El Camino?
Yeah, we've seen it.
Okay. Yeah. The fact that fucking Todd is 50 pounds overweight, it's weird, bro. It's weird. Like, it's like you're wanting to do these flashbacks, but Todd is big, bro. That dude, Todd.
The guy that you asked about, the guy that keeps him in.
The redhead dude. Yeah, and like takes him out, and like he's the one that's like takes him back to that place so they could go get that chick and then go bury her and shit like that. Then he fucking has the gun in his thing. And he's like, "Hey man, I was thinking about getting you some pizza, you know." And then he gives him the gun back and shit. It's crazy to think. Like, I mean, it was good.
Stockholm syndrome.
Okay,
that's what that was.
Is that what that is?
He felt bad for his captor.
He's like, "Motherfucker, I could murk you right now and put you in this hole I'm digging."
What'd you think of it as a whole?
It was all right.
Yeah, I seen it.
I don't want to say it was great, but it was decent.
Yeah,
I wanted more, man. Decent.
Yeah, it left me wanting so much more. Like that's what I
at the same time though, like what wasn't covered, like
A lot of people said that they wanted more. They wanted to see what happened with Skyler and her Walter fucking son. Died. And then obviously, but then also what happened to, what was his name? The cop's wife, the bitch that loved purple and shit like that. Like, what happened to her? Because, you know, we didn't get to see it, but they probably might have shown, like, them finding the bodies and having the fucking funerals for both Hank and what was his name? What was his partner's name? Little Mexican dude? Porcito? Yeah. He fucking died and shit. So, but it was decent. It was decent.
Well, you saw how Jesse got away.
Yeah, right.
That's it. That's what that movie was about, how Jesse got away.
I was fucking cracking up when he was making him do the whole, like, run on the line shit and then jump and try to break that shit. I was like, I bet my fucking big ass could have broke that shit somehow, dog. I shit you not.
Bro, man, I would have fucking hurt, like, in real life to really do that.
Yeah. He had a harness on, though, dog. As long as it wasn't, like, wrapped around his ball sack, he would have been all right, I think.
That shit is yanking him out. Boom, he's full force, just running every time. Just like.
Yeah, it does suck. He was a little fucker. And he, yeah. It was decent though, but it was funny though. It was kind of like they wanted you to show how.
Would you have shot the dude in that situation?
Me personally,
yes, you.
Yeah. Oh well, I mean, okay. This is the thing.
That was dope. That standoff.
He was different because.
Yeah, for sure. I expected.
I saw that though. I saw that shit
with
coming.
The other
I was
one
like,
right here.
I was like, he's got a fucking 45 on him somewhere, dog. I'm like, it's in his pocket. His hand is in his pocket. I kind of saw that shit coming, dude. But it was good. It was still good. You know, it was still good. But the times where he talked to that dude out of killing him in that apartment, and like you see like the Walter White come out in him, here's what's gonna happen. You're not gonna shoot me with that guy over there because you gotta bury the man in room 409 and blah blah blah. So it was kind of like okay, Walter, chill the fuck out, you know what I'm saying? But I mean it was cool. It was definitely good. It wasn't the greatest, but it was definitely good, you know what I'm saying?
It was a nice continuation knowing that the series is over.
Right. And then, yeah, Zombieland 2 was fucking, it was pretty fucking hilarious.
Do you watch that Wu-Tang episode that came out?
Bro, that was good.
I haven't seen the newest one, though. The last one, the one I just finished, was where he did that corny-ass video.
Okay, I did and the one where he starts fucking with the Jamaican.
Okay.
So, I think there's one more out that I haven't caught yet. But, yo, it's good. It's a good series.
It is good.
I fuck with it heavy.
It is a good-ass
series. I think it's finally starting to kick up with this next episode. Because it's been kind of slow. But, like, I didn't get...
My thing was, how many seasons are they trying to make it?
What's that?
Is there a plan on how many seasons they're trying to make it?
Because I think they're probably... from what I hear, like a lot of shows, they don't go in unless you're like something like Game of Thrones, where it's like off top, you're getting six seasons and shit, and then they start pushing it from there. Shows like that, sometimes they're just like, we're going to see how this season goes, and then we'll let you know. It's kind of... That's how Ozark was.
But they're already at episode, what, like 10?
Somewhere in there, but that's still not a full season.
12 is a season?
I mean, it depends.
Like seasons seem to get like shorter and shorter each
season. Yeah, I mean Ozark is like 9.
Stranger Things is 8.
What about Peaky Blinders?
I haven't seen that one.
That's just good.
That's the second time someone's brought that one up. I heard it's good.
I haven't seen season 3 yet.
I haven't seen it, but yeah, we're gonna check that shit out. And
Watchmen came out.
I heard that.
I haven't seen
it either. I'm gonna have to subscribe to HBO again.
There it is. Okay. Hey, have you ever seen
Disney
Euphoria?
Plus? Right, drops next month.
No, I haven't.
You ever seen Euphoria? Watch Euphoria. It's on HBO.
Okay.
With that bad one. What's her name? Zendaya.
Okay.
Yeah, she's in there. She's like a kind of a druggie that just got out of rehab, and she meets like this friend of hers, and all these friends.
Something like that.
What is it?
Catherine.
No, it's just Zendaya. That's her name, Zendaya.
I thought she was a singer.
She's a singer.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I know who.
Yeah, that one's good. Okay. Okay, so moving into fashion and pop culture, the stairs on the Joker that he was going up and down. It's in I want to say it's in the Bronx, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Now on Google, when you look those up, they're literally called the Joker stairs. And it's just been packed as fuck down there with people going and taking the fucking pictures of themselves doing this shit and doing all kinds of crazy shit like what he was doing in the fucking show. So,
Damn, it's fucking crazy. Someone had to check it out.
Dude, you're going to fucking, I'm telling you, bro, you got to watch it in the fucking theaters, bro. Like, experience it. Because honestly, I'm going to tell you the one thing that stood out to me the most on this movie, and a lot of it probably has to do with because it was in the theater, but the music. The score, the music, when he's in these situations where he's just sitting there by himself, like the music makes you feel like you know what he's thinking. Yeah. It puts you in his mood. It puts you in his fucking, like in his space. And the music is just, it fucking helps you along with the cinematography and his fucking acting, bro. Like I'm telling you, I feel like they're going to clean up at the fucking awards next year. They really are, dog. It's a good fucking movie, man. Definitely check it out before it's out of the theater.
For sure. I'm going to check it out probably this weekend. Definitely.
Do that I'm going to digital copy by it.
Oh, yeah. But you should still go watch it. Oh, you already saw it. Okay, so moving into something new.
Yummy.
It was my week this week again. And I went old school little fat kid this week. And everybody knows, of course, Keeblers. They got them fudge stripes. But these ones, I didn't even know it said that right there. It says hashtag fully fudged. Hashtag fully fudged, bro. They're called the Whoopsie Fudge Stripes. So you know what fudge stripes are. It's got chocolate on the bottom and it's got the stripes on the top. Well, the Whoopsie is they drop the whole fucking cookie into the chocolate and it's completely covered in chocolate. It's good. To me, I feel like it's a great balance. I give it five forks.
What's a five mic system?
That's music. That's like the source.
Okay.
That's five mics, I think. But yeah, we do five forks. So I give it five forks. It was good shit. What did you think about it?
Yeah, I give it five forks.
You've been over here fucking tearing them up and shit.
Shout out these Betty's papers.
Right? What do you think? You know what? You don't taste nothing, right? No aftertaste or nothing like that. Look at this. Damn, dog. You roll a nice joint right here. Look at this.
Dog, everyone enjoys the song.
Nice.
I've been the master roller for sure. This one can't roll with
your
blunt
shit. Oh, man. It's good to have your own private roller.
On 420, we fucking did like this huge blunt wrap. You know the cones?
Was it the Wiz Khalifa cones?
No, I forgot what brand it was.
It was a raw.
It was like a juicy, right?
It was a big-ass raw or something like that, I thought.
Well, one of them we stuffed. No, that wasn't that stuff. I peeled it. So it looked like a towel paper roll. Fucking, I had like a pound on me. And we fucking just fucking.
This year?
Yeah. And we rolled this fucking mean old cigar. It was like a foot long, bro. Oh, shit. That was a special edition, though, because that's like a total waste of weed.
Oh, you guys did a whole video for it, right?
That was on 420.
Yeah.
We so had, we had food, audio right? over here.
No, that was episode 20.
He's like, that was episode 20.
The 420, the 420 episode was somewhere in there, but it was dope, dog. Like, we got someone fucking lit. And we just bought, we bought pizza. No, the 20th episode, which was the end of season one, we brought in my homeboy, Chef Mondo. And he made pulled pork. But he made three different sauces, and all the sauces had weed infused into them. And he made baked beans. Get it? Baked beans. And then he made cornbread that had infused weed on it. And when he baked the cornbread, somebody actually gave him like a fucking dried marijuana leaf, and he put it on it and shit. I have pictures of it. It's fucking awesome. And yeah, dude, we got... I mean... It didn't like put me like, whoa, like I'm feeling it, bro. Like I think he was more nervous about like if people get way too fucked up, this is my fault. But he so he went kind of light on it. Yeah. Did I feel something? Yeah, I kind of did. I felt relaxed like when we recorded afterwards and shit. Right. It was cool. But I definitely would have liked to have felt like a little bit more and shit. But he's gonna be doing that shit again here for us soon, dog. Hell like we're gonna have another little fucking get together.
Like it's gonna be a small
When we do like the Hood Diner re-grand opening in this bitch, he's gonna be in here. He might be donating a bar, a Hood Diner bar. He's been making those bars out of pallets,
yeah,
and shit like that. I might break him off. I don't have to break him off something for
something
like
off top.
But he said he might be making a new Hood Diner bar. So like I told you, it'd be dope to have one right there in the corner, so that boom, drinks, everything right there, a little fridge or something. You know what I'm saying?
Keep the ice and shit.
A little spot to put out some food right over here. And
oh,
shit
you'll
like
put
that.
Out.
Yeah. Put it out, baby. And then we're gonna do like a green screen right here on this wall over here.
Food.
Oh, yeah, you want to get in on them noodles or what?
Shit, I got to get some fucking plates and shit. Let me go get that.
You going to do that for real?
I mean,
you know. She made them for you for like a potluck or something?
I don't know what she was. She dropped off some noodles and
she going to take for like a potluck?
We're going to take a noodle break here for a second.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
This is One Armed Ninja from Failing Hollywood Podcast.
It's Mikey T.
Paranormal Fuckboy Freddy.
That's right. And you are listening to The Hood Diner with homie Kaz and DJ Century.
Yeah, buddy.
I know when I go to a neighborhood diner, I like to order Irish Eggs Benedict. That's Eggs Benedict with corned beef hash.
I get mozzarella sticks and mozzarella sticks.
Yeah, Sir Kaz will be on you. Inner Circle, guys. Check it out.
A few moments later...
The barber community shows so much more love than like the hip hop community, bro. Like, to be honest, like the barber shops and shit, they give me to print shirts. Like, I've done, you know, like just everything. I feel like the barber community is like always hold it down,
dude. It's a cash business, bro. They got cash on them,
yeah,
all the time,
at all times, you know. And I feel like that's what happens with a lot of hip hop, is I just feel like, you know, the ideas in there, you know, but everybody, there's a reason they call it. You were talking about, I was talking with somebody.
Starving artist.
We call it.
That's what I was talking to you about that on Sunday, dog. Exactly. Yes, dog. I was, because exactly. We were talking about like videos and shit like that, dude. And I was like, dude, like my main focus right now is kind of more into doing like commercials for businesses and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like being with like actual companies that will put you on retainer and do shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like that's kind of like the focus right now and shit like that. But I still am. Dabbling into like music videos and doing, you know, promo videos and shit like that. My nephew's a barber, so I told him, I'm like, I want to do a video for you. You know what I'm saying? Like little shit like that where he's cutting hair and shit. But I had fun, dog. I think it was the first battle that I've been to where I did take video. Normally, like the battles that we did, the Clipper Combats and shit, I would roam around and take pictures and shit, but I wasn't ever in charge of the video. And I never did the video part. This time I had a good ass time doing it and shit, but I felt it was a couple times I felt I got a little bit too close for comfort and shit. I almost bumped into one of the barbers while they were doing some hair and shit. I was like, oh fuck, do you imagine? You imagine if I fucking hit him and he fucking brrr, like fuck some dude's hair up?
Man.
Oh my god! I was like, what happened? Fucking Casual got hit in the face.
He said,
Casual got hit in the face, dude, with a fucking clipper. But
He's like, Calvin got socked.
But
up.
Yeah, no, dog, the fucking dude, the barber industry, bro, it's a dope ass industry, dog. I got a lot of clients in the barber industry, bro. A lot of my shout money comes from the barber industry.
They always,
real,
they always hold it down.
They do.
Got a bunch of good homies that are barbers, actually. You know, a lot of my homies cut hair, to be honest, and I go to all of them, to be honest. At one point, I've hit up all my homies, you know, cut my hair. But, you know, shout out them. Like, they're always, you know, you're right. You know, they always got cash on hand. And they're just, everybody, you know, they're always willing to work. And
they understand like the that. Grind, dog.
And it's cool. They be throwing their own events like that. So it's always cool because, you know, it's different. It's a little bit different of an atmosphere, but it's still a hip-hop feel. You know, because, you know, barber battle is like kind of what, like in hip hop will be just like a regular show, you know, like on a Saturday night, right, or some shit like that.
They're a little more focused on the show, though, just a little bit sometimes and shit. Exactly. What's his name? So what did he say? He's a fucking shit crowd. And I was like, dude, it's a different fucking environment. You know what I'm saying?
Tough crowd.
Tough crowd. Okay. Yeah, I'm thinking of fucking, what's his name? Million Ways to Die in the West.
Seth MacFarlane.
No, yeah. Well, the other dude, he came out. He was all shit crowd. It was fucking funny. Anyways, man. But yeah, shout out to them, dog. It was a good fucking day, man.
Hell yeah.
Had fun and shit.
Shout out Barbara Mel and Richie the Barber.
Yep. Shout out to them and shit. Yeah. We were talking about food right now. You just had some of these noodles. What was her name again?
Jasmine.
Jasmine. Shout out to Jasmine. She brought you some.
Yeah, her mom lives around the corner and. She fucking was making food for a potluck or something, I think.
Boom! I was right. I told you. I told when you took off, I was like, what is it, for a potluck? And he was all laughing. He's a fucking potluck. I was like, it was a potluck.
I'm not 100%, but that's what I think it is.
Okay. Well, shout out to her.
Nonetheless, she gave us good? A full fucking tray of that shit.
They were good?
Yeah.
They were good? What'd you think?
Yeah, they were good.
They're good. I'll try a little bit right now as soon as we're done and shit right now.
I like cabbage, to be honest. Like, I like noodles with cabbage in it. Like,
cabbage is fire in like Oriental food.
Yes, fire.
I love cabbage,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, definitely. Fucking
that's some good shit.
You just slice up some chicken and throw it in that shit. Forget about it.
Yeah.
Forget about it.
You know? We dipped out talking about the damn cookies and shit, but the other thing I had in food was that the White Castle in Scottsdale finally opened.
You know, 808 put.
Yeah, he's all motherfuckers don't know how to act and shit. Yeah, I saw that. Actually, that's kind of what made me write it down because I was like, oh shit, it is open. And then when I go to like my Twitter shit where it showed like the shit that's trending, it was fucking actually trending and shit. It's all White Castle and Scottsdale is open and shit and people are losing their shit. It's good, man. We have to go up there one of these days.
I've been in White Castle. I don't think it's that great.
Why?
I mean, dude, they're all right. They're all right. They're good.
There's this place in Seattle called Dick's. There's a place in Seattle called Dick's.
It's called Dick's. Okay.
Shout out Dick's.
It's a what do they got there?
It's a burger joint, but it's they don't make anything like custom order. Like you could get your burger.
It is what it is.
You could get your burger plain, or you could get it like the Dick's Deluxe, or you could get it like.
Or the Dick's. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I be serving.
But it was this dude. His name was Dick, I guess, or whatever.
Dick was a dick and named it after himself. But
they made it for like instant service. So, you know, like you get your food right then and there. They pass you it. They always got burgers on right there. Just bam. So you get it at the door. And they serve.
Get that dick real quick. get them dicks real quick. Dicks on the quick.
It's a burger spot.
Fuck yeah. You said it was like in
it's in Seattle. That's Seattle? Why we had it. Yeah.
I want to go to Seattle, man. That's one of my spots I want to go
I've been there
check
once,
out.
But I was like 12.
Was it gloomy?
I went there this past summer. It was
fucking awesome.
No, we
was like the
like,
weather all gloomy or was it
no,
nice?
It was like really clear. Like
every day we were there, no rain, nothing, no clouds.
Either. See, that's what I hear. I hear it rains a lot over there, so it's just gloomy.
I love the
as
rain.
Fuck.
I was
fuck
hoping
rain
it would
too,
rain.
But
heavy.
But you never know, man. It might be different in places like that.
I mean, I don't want to go through a hurricane, but.
Well, like they said that like over there, like it's during the winter time. It's only like light for like 3-4 hours a day.
Yeah, okay. I'm with
and
that.
Everything else, it's not dark, but like everything's just covered in clouds. And,
yeah,
like, you just can't see anything.
Bro, I'm going to Alaska like next year.
Okay.
I'm excited for that. I'm gonna go see those the Borealis, Aurora Borealis fucking lights,
Aurora Borealis,
them green lights and shit like that, dog. Yeah. Dude, we're gonna do some fucking
the Northern Lights.
We're gonna do ice fishing and fucking ride them fucking little fucking dog sleds and shit like that. My lady copped a package and shit, dude. It's gonna be fun as fuck, bro. I'm excited about that shit, man.
Hell yeah.
But
he's all shout out my lady for
right.
That.
Fuck yeah, thank you, babe. Okay, sports.
Sports. fucking Yankees lost.
Shout out Sam PC. They were hurt, bro.
Yo, the fucking Astros are getting worked in the World Series.
Are they really? So is that who won tonight? The Nationals won tonight?
Beat their ass.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, man.
And then speaking of fucking ass beating, fucking our teams took ass beating this weekend.
Did the Lakers win last night?
Fuck the Lakers.
That was your
Suns fan.
I know. I'm just asking.
So they won then, huh?
They lost. They lost against the Clippers.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Did they really? Oh, man, that's not good.
Kawhi Leonard, dog. He's the fucking truth, man.
Okay, good. Shout out him doing the shit.
Of course. Yeah, they so. Playing there, huh? Two best stars now. LA's the powerhouse.
Right for
now.
Sure.
Both teams.
Yeah, ASU spotlight. Lost. U of A lost. ASU's still ranked, though. They're 24th.
Okay. They're holding on by a thread right there. Living they got that, pink. They got that. They got that pinky I on forgot. The ledge and shit. They're like.
We got UCLA this weekend.
We're in this bitch.
We can beat them.
Okay,
we lost. Suns kicked it off tonight against Sacramento.
And how did that go?
They won.
They won. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
The Suns are nasty,
bro. Devin Booker, DeAndre Ayton. Forget about it.
Let's go see some games this year.
I'm with it.
I'm definitely. I wanted to go see like sit courtside at least once,
bro. That's right a little here. Pricey.
But you
need to relax. Nah.
But I mean, like, I'm just down to go.
He's. I just want to throw down three racks on a game. Fuck it. I mean, I'd have to see LeBron or I'd have to see, like, a top-tier talent for me to throw down that kind of money, you know? Yeah. LeBron's last game, you know?
Okay.
That type of shit.
But I think you could probably get floor seats to a Sun game, probably, like, 500.
Fuck, season, no.
700.
More than that, dog. You're probably, like, two racks.
Two racks, a seat?
So to where you probably can catch the ball and hit a jump shot, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. You grab it. Are you hand it to him real quick? Talk some all right, shit real
I'm
quick.
I'm gonna put that in bag five.
Oh, cross him over.
All right, maybe my goal. All right, maybe my
real
goal.
Real quick, all right, go.
All right, my goal. Maybe this.
Do a little round the back
year,
shit.
Oh, you go. Five rows back.
Some animal mixtape shit. You're off. I feel like
that's just 2021 will be in the top three rows. Then
one of these days you're gonna get that opportunity. You give it to him. You're like, oh. Fucking and one his ass real quick. Okay, man. Music, moving into our fucking jams of the week and shit, dog. I don't know if I told you about that or if you've heard it on the podcast, but every week we try to find a song that we hadn't heard like within the last week. Every week we try to find, it helps us continue to look for new music and shit like that. And then we pick an old school song. So think of something new that you just heard and then think of like an old school song that you like and shit. Okay. And I'll go ahead and start off. Frank Ocean dropped a new song called DHL. And it's pretty dope. It's a laid-back little R&B joint and shit like that. I don't think you probably like want to play it in the club and shit. It's more like you're fucking chilling at the house, cleaning.
Listening, you know what I dropped? I dropped Novocaine.
Around with rolling around with your shorty. You know what I'm saying?
Novocaine.
Yeah, that shit goes hard in the club.
Yeah.
It's like a time filler. Like, you need to just to put a song on until people get there.
Okay.
That's a good opener.
Okay. I was listening to some dope-ass Nipsey that you were playing the other day and shit. Like, shit that you wouldn't hear in the fucking, you know, clubs and shit like that, dude. But it was good. Yeah? It was good shit, though. It was good shit, though, dude.
What's your throwback?
My throwback is Denise Williams, Free.
Okay.
You know who that is, right? Then I just got to be free. You know what I'm talking about? That old shit? Watch.
Yeah, watch.
Watch, check this shit
out. All right, let's check it out. Okay.
It's been redone by rappers left and right, you know what I'm saying? I even have an instrumental somewhere that has this beat like that, dude. It's dope, dude. Yeah, that's a clean ass little joint right there, dog. That's my old school gem of the week. What do you got this week?
So some dude requested this fucking song at Cobra this last weekend.
Oh shit, DJ Century took a request.
Berner and Currency.
Okay.
Reasons. Okay. He shouts out Tucson in this.
That snap is loud as shit.
He shouts out Tucson in
this. Does he? Oh yeah, somebody told me about that. That he has a song that he snaps.
It's a slapper.
It's a slapper. Okay.
And then my throwback is I play this again at the club for the first time in God knows how long. Some Roscoe Dash.
Okay.
This used to go so fucking hard.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, that's my throwback of the fucking week. Because it gets really good response in the club. Yo, Friday was really good considering it was a Friday. I had a fucking couple dance moments.
Okay.
Lasted like, you know, 4 or 5 songs.
Yep.
Then they dispersed. You know, I had that a couple throughout the night. So, but you know.
Please disperse.
No, bro. It's so hard to fucking DJ Friday nights there.
Disperse.
Yeah.
Because of the location, bro.
Yeah, I get you.
You know?
I get you.
You experience that when you DJ on Fridays?
Yeah, Fridays or sometimes even Saturdays too. Saturdays a little bit different.
Yeah, luckily for me, Saturdays have been cracking, you know?
I feel that. You've been dropping that. What you been playing in there?
This everything, bro. Like Latin, fucking, you know, cumbias, fucking reggaeton.
Oh, man, he would have killed it at fucking that shit. He's got reggaeton like a motherfucker, bro. Yeah, you need to break him off some fucking shit. He said he didn't have too much reggaeton and shit.
Yeah, I mean, I can't.
Get him
what's crazy?
Get him a playlist.
I'm switching over to Tidal.
That's where you're going?
Because you can download. Or Spotify, I don't know yet. Probably going to go Spotify.
I feel like Spotify is universal.
You can download the music to your laptop, and you can use it in Serato. So you don't even have to buy it anymore.
I see that.
Yeah, bro. So you can make crates and shit. Like, it's legit. Like, it's fucking legit. I have 500 fucking gigabytes on here.
Did you guys Shazam that right there?
Yeah.
Did you guys Shazam that beat? Or is it me that's playing over here still? It is me, huh? I was all over here thinking, I'm like, look at him. He's got it on over there. It's all low. So I'm hearing it from over here. Shit. I'm all, okay. They like the song. They like the old school. What do you got, dog? What's something new you heard this week? Something you just added to your rotation?
Travis Scott, Highest in the Room.
Oh, yeah. Shit. Okay. That was his week before last, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's so
good. It's a good jam.
Yeah,
it's
so a dope I just started throwing it in there. It's definitely
that beat is creepy.
The beat
as
is
fuck.
Crazy. It's the beat is crazy. Definitely the beat kills for sure. I don't think he gets too crazy lyrical wise, but I mean, I think he does just enough.
But does he ever?
I mean, I think he's more vocal on some songs, but
he's not a wordsmith.
Yeah, definitely.
A wordsmith.
I think old Travis is for sure. I think he's just gone with too much of a melody right now. Like,
well, Mamacita.
That's not saying that's bad.
Well, Mamacita era.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was hard.
Fucking, he's a Maria.
That's the
he was cracking me up with the sprinkle of the taiga.
Yeah, well, that's how it is. All the dance tracks have fucking goddamn taiga in it.
Yup.
He's all, how the fuck did he get a second revival?
Bro, he's killing it.
Bro, it's
he's
like they have like clear and they fucking rub those magnets. We hit him in the chest, bro, and he's like, all right.
Wait.
Yeah.
Wait. On top of all of that, what about him, like, him and Kylie being in the studio?
Right.
Dude, we talked about this.
He just got a kid. He's got.
No.
He's like, they always come back. He goes, they always come back.
Right? It's all right. Anyways, I read that she was dropping off like one of her homegirls at the fucking studio or some shit. Yeah, dude, but
you know what I mean?
Regardless, that's all. I mean, hey, why the fuck not, dude? You know what I'm saying? It's not like her and what's his face are together anymore, right?
So I'll say, apparently, he's got a girlfriend that looks apparently
who,
like.
Who, Tyga?
No.
Oh, Travis Scott already?
Yeah, no, bro. He's had this girlfriend like with when he was with Kylie.
Oh, okay.
Like, there's pictures of her like all over Twitter. It's just, bro, and she looks exactly like Kylie.
No
like,
shit,
like,
huh?
But like a natural version.
Okay. Okay. He's like, I found that. I found the vegan the vegan model of you.
He's like, I found the hood version of you, the real version of you.
Yeah, it's without the plastic. Steroids and the implants.
Yeah. Mm,
the vegan, I'm telling you.
Version.
Okay.
I found the GMO free version.
Right?
The kosher.
Natural. All natural.
The kosher version.
Right? Exactly. What's something old school? Like something that you just love to fucking throw in the mix, dog? Like, it's like something that's older or, you know, not too new.
I'm going to say 50 Cent 21 Questions.
That's a banger, shit. Too. That's a banger.
Oh, love this shit or what? Like,
it's either joke. Love me now.
He just kills it.
Love me if I was down. Fucking Nate Dogg, bro. Rest in peace.
For real.
All right, dog. So what was it that got you into DJing and shit?
Damn. Honestly, Rip D got me into DJing.
Okay.
Yeah, so honestly, he started he taught me how to DJ. And I started learning from there and he started putting me on shows. And yeah, that's how I started DJing.
Okay, that's dope. But now, more than just DJing, you're like you're J Tilt's personal DJ, right?
Yeah.
Like, so you guys fucking, dude, I love the chemistry that you guys have. When for a minute there, it almost seemed like they were running out. They weren't gonna do the last performers. I saw you kind of like went out there and like told him like, "Hey man, like my dude still wants to perform and shit."
Yeah, well, always
because it looked like they were gonna fucking, you know, like they were getting ready to announce the shit like that. So just before the winners went out, like Jay got to do his set. You know,
it was even better because everybody was right there thinking that they're about to do like awards and like we got the whole crowd right there.
And did you just tell me where you guys were just gonna do like two songs real quick, like just real quick,
just to like, get a little something? Yeah, always like a little.
That was cool, man.
Just wanted like a little small little thing.
You went in there, threw it down, ended with the no setbacks and shit and fucking, because I noticed Alva was getting the mic and shit, dude, and Alva was like doing the fucking ad libs and shit like that with him, dude. It was fun, dog. It was good shit. I was down there getting photos and getting some video of him and shit like that, dude. It was cool. Yeah. But it was a cool ass event and shit, man. So, but did you say your old school song?
What's that?
Oh, yeah. He said the old school song, right? Because that's how we moved on.
Yeah, duh. Yeah.
Fucking dumb.
21 questions.
See what happens, dog?
It's the weed.
Smoking and shit. Yeah, I would like that.
It's the weed.
So, okay. So, we spoke about the new mixing board. Let me see. How long ago did you start the Poison Boyz?
Well, actually, wait. Before you go further with that, what would you say that you would improve on that controller? Like, if you had to say, I just wish this had this.
The thing is that I don't like about it is that the two platter decks, they're like mirrored, so the play buttons are on like the each side of your thumb like that, so they're both on the inside, not like how on other controllers, or you know,
they're
like
standard on the left,
know, like, or if it's standard on the right, like if you're on turntable then it's on the right. Then it's always on the right no matter where you place your turntable, because you're not going to place it backwards where it's in the left hand corner,
right?
So it's always going to be in the right spot right there. So I don't like how they're mirrored, so it's like right here, because I feel like, you know, like whenever you're moving this or whatever, you stop playing that one because the play button's right there. And I don't like that, because I feel like, you know, like,
so it's a little clunky then.
It's just like if you're scratching and stuff, because the controller's smaller, like a smaller area workspace. Like I feel like if you're like moving the jog wheel and you hit that play button, your whole track on the left side is gonna stop, and you know, that means that's going to stop everything that's playing, you know, on the floor. So,
okay.
That would probably be the one improvement I would make on it.
You know, I got them phase.
I know it.
Game changer, bro.
Game changer?
Yeah.
Definitely a great investment.
Well, you fucking saw Jay with the fucking record going like this. It was even on the turntable.
Oh, my God.
And it was scratching.
You're right.
It's just so dope.
Wait, so how does it mount to the record?
There's a little magnetic strip you put on the top, and it has like adhesive on the back, and that's a magnet. And then you throw the USB on top of it, and it like clicks in, so it's like it's married to the vinyl.
Okay.
Like it's glued right there, and the rotation is what it represents, you know.
Right. But so you can get
the
off?
You get the record off of the actual turntable, and you just shake it, and it'll make noise. You know, right. And that's what Jay was doing, you know?
Yeah.
It was fucking tight. I'm going to be at Highwire again pretty soon.
So it's basically like the needle, not even
needleless.
All so you're it's a using digital needle.
It's all you need is the turntable for the platter to spin.
It's a digital needle.
Boy, so overall, though, what would you rate it?
I rated it 8 out of 10.
Okay.
So it's not enough to return it because you don't like it?
No, I love it. I'm going to keep it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Just got to get used to being careful and not hit that fucking button and shit.
Yeah, just basically just make sure I just practice with it and get used to it before I start, you know.
That's cool. Going in?
Yeah, you know what I mean? Because then once you get sloppy and stuff like that, then, you know, you make those mistakes. Dancing and shit like that into the groove because you're not paying attention. Now I'm, like, really careful, like, where I place my hands, but so.
How did you link up with Jay?
Honestly, we met at Cash's album release party.
Okay.
He was a performer. Cash asked him to perform. This was like a while back. We had a show like at a warehouse, and we got linked up there. And then I've been his DJ ever since. I spun for him what he was like DJing, and then we started having shows like at The Rock, and we were doing shows and stuff like that, opening up for people and doing, you know, other events. So, and then we just started rocking and then learned it. And then this last album, we actually like went up to Vegas, and like I got there and like we worked the whole process together.
Who did you guys do that with again?
That was with Reezy.
With Reezy, right?
Yeah, Reezy.
He's on Dizzy Wright's label, is it?
Yeah, Still Moving.
Okay.
So, yeah, so he's one of Dizzy Wright's producers, you know, one of Dizzy Wright's engineers. So, and definitely we got a track on there, you know, called Black Van with Dizzy Wright on it. So check that out. And that's J-Till, No Setbacks. But yeah, so that was like
shit right there, bro.
So it was hella cool, like, you know, just sitting in the studio and just you know, experience all of that.
Just vibing, fucking, just being there to help him out and shit like that, dude. That's dope, man. Like, I definitely give you a shout out for being like a dope fucking, like, you know, homie to him and fucking having his back and, you know, spinning for him and shit like that. Yeah, man. Y'all's chemistry is dope, dude. Keep that shit up right there. So back to the Poison Boyz. What made you want to What made you want to start your own brand?
I just like wanted to like I wanted my own like kind of I wanted to wear my own clothes.
Right.
Like a dislike. There wasn't like a brand that I was thought was so super cool at that time or still really nothing that I think is crazy that I'm just like, I gotta wear like everything. Like,
word.
You know, like,
I'm a word.
Were you big in a Supreme?
No, like, and that's what I'm saying. Like, none of them really ever, not to mention, like, you know, I couldn't really afford, you know, like,
right.
Some of those things be selling.
$400
like,
shirts.
Yeah, and then you can't get it, you know, when it sells, it drops. So you're even having to pay like 3 times the price. So it's like, no, so I want to wear something of my own that, like, at least got cool designs, you know, and I could make it look. And I just liked everything, like, black at the time. So I just, like, wanted to put things on black shirts.
Hmm.
So that's how it basically started. And then I just thinking of, like, a cool name, and I was like, Poison Boyz Apparel. And then, so now we have it, it's Poison Boyz, and then we go, like, Apparel Epidemic. So we added the epidemic part when we, like, did the rebranding for the, like, when we the website dropped and everything like that. So, but yeah, it's been good. And yeah, we started that in 2017.
Nice.
That was like when we first did like our first, you know, anything, any shirts. We started in 2017 and then kind of, yeah, and then so kind of just been building off of that ever since. You know, this time we dropped, we dropped 10 different shirts on this last one. We dropped shorts, pants, 3 different hats, a backpack, 2 bags. We definitely just like try to do our thing this time and just do a bunch of different products.
Dope, man.
So hell yeah, it was really cool.
Would you ever move away from Tucson to further your career?
Yeah, honestly, I'm honestly not from here. I'm from Carlsbad, New Mexico.
But, okay.
Yeah, so I came up here. My aunt lives up here. We moved up here, and I graduated from high school here. But it's not my home. You know, and Tucson is just like a stepping stone, I feel like, you know, and I eventually want to take my talents to Portland, Oregon.
Okay.
So that's the spot I hopefully feel like.
That's like the next move right there?
Yeah, just what? Like I'm dead ready for a climate change. Like I think I'm over the desert for a while.
You're going to grow a beard and fucking wear a fucking flannel?
Something like that. Maybe.
Some boots and shit, some Timbos all day?
Maybe. I mean.
Well, it is beard gang, you know.
I feel you. I'm trying it. I'm over beard. Here.
Struggle beard.
Yup.
I had that struggle beard for the longest time, man.
Yeah.
It was all
they
patchy.
Say it happens with
I
age.
I grow in like
it
an
does,
animal.
Bro. And eventually all of a sudden this shit came out crazy as fuck.
Yeah, bro. Dude. Then you have to shave areas you never thought you'd have to shave.
Right. So what's the 5-year plan, dog? What do you see yourself in like 5 years?
I'll hopefully see myself in Portland, you know, in the next couple of years. And then hopefully I want to build like a shop there, you know, and I got some plans to, you know, do a shop out there. But yeah, that's the eventual plan.
Okay.
You know, just have a build myself as an artist as well, you know, as a DJ. You know, I think I'm going to do getting myself into production as well.
Okay.
This whole started spitting.
Yeah. I also started rapping too.
Shut the fuck up. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Got that Dylon flow.
We got some shit coming.
Spit out
the
fire.
Sure.
Fuck yeah, man. That's dope as fuck, dog.
Hell yeah.
Okay, dog. Sure, so before we wrap up, dog, cool. We do the island question, dog. All
right.
It's where you're all alone on an island and you only get to have one book, one album, one movie, and one food. What are they?
All right. Y'all go first. Let me think about this one. What about you?
Oh, fuck. Nobody's ever asked us, huh?
No, we said them.
I mean, we said them like on the first podcast and shit.
That's
a long time ago. I don't even remember either. I know my one food is fucking
okay, so
mariscos.
Food, food, music, and then
a book and a movie.
Book, a movie, music, and food.
Yeah, like one album.
Okay.
And one book and one food.
All right. So if I'm trapped on this island, I think I would take beef jerky.
Okay, forever, bro. Because you can have anything you want, bro. Like, there's going to be a lifetime supply of it there. Okay. Like a fucking big ass freezer full of fucking lobsters if you want. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, but I don't know if I could do lobster every day. And I
mean, you don't have to. It's just for an example. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever it is you want, there's a lifetime supply of it until you die. You know what I'm saying? So I always say that. I say as long as you're alive on this island, because like, let's say, I've always given the example of, let's say your fucking one food is fried chicken, and like fucking probably less than a couple years, your arteries are going to go, bro. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to take a salad.
Okay.
I'm going to take a salad. Probably like a salad. I would take a Caesar salad, honestly. That dressing would be kind of filling all the time, or like maybe a vinaigrette salad.
Okay.
Maybe like a chicken
salad. Just be like just a fucking full salad bar. Yeah, this way, every day of the week, you can do a chef salad one day. You could do a Asian salad the next day. You know what I'm saying? Okay. What movie or book?
Oh, that the book's the hard part. That's the one I'm stuck on. I'm still thinking about it in the back of my head. But movie, I would take Step Brothers or Talladega Nights.
Yeah, I'd probably go.
I'd rather laugh if I'm gonna be trapped on an island. Like, I'd rather laugh the whole time. So
after like the 100th time, it's all ha 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 ha. It's like all fake sinister laugh and shit. Just fucking.
But shit, if you watch something, if you watch something depressing like 3 times, you're gonna be like, fuck this, like
off yourself.
Yeah, you know what I mean. I'd rather at least make it 100 plays.
Yeah, I get you.
You say one album.
I get you.
Okay.
One album, or one book too. People put people on the spot all lit and shit. Huh? It's probably like not the right thing to do, but you know.
I'm gonna say the Bible.
Okay, a lot of people say the Bible.
Common theme.
A lot of people say the Bible.
You feel like you get some good reading in, you might, you know, rediscover yourself.
Hey, bro, if the aliens are true, do you think God's real?
God damn! If the aliens are true, do I think God's real? Bro, I can't answer these questions. I'm gonna plead the fifth on
this
one.
That's a deep ass question, though. That's a good ass question, honestly.
But
book?
Yeah.
Okay.
Album, I would have to say Carlos Santana album. Probably like
Supernatural?
Or
the one with Black Magic Woman and shit like that?
Yeah, I think I'd take
that. That old school one? Like, I think that one's Dancer super. Or something like I think it's that. Supernatural, isn't it?
Supernatural is the newer
one. That's that newer one, right? One
that with Smooth.
Yeah, the fucking
goddamn Rob Thomas and shit, bro.
Yeah.
I think that's on with like Black Magic Woman and shit.
Yeah, I
like
think
that,
it's like it's called like Moon Dancer.
Something like that. Yeah. That's a good
one. So I take that because I feel like, you know, if I'm on this island, like, I'm gonna chill and just dance. You know, like I feel like I would take some or try to take some hip hop, but it's just too harsh to listen to. I'm like, this is not, you know what I mean?
Right, with this beach and shit, and you're just out there and you're just like,
you know
wanna be fucking vibing to those fucking waves and shit. You're gonna just wait your days out and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So definitely, man. Well, fucking.
For sure.
Okay, so that was the book, the album, the movie. Okay, let me see. So before we wrap up, tell everybody one more time where they can find you and where they can find your brand.
So you can find me at DJ Young Alva on everything. That's DJ YUNGALVA, and then that's on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and you can find my brand. It's called Poison Boyz Apparel. You can find that online on our website at poisonboyz.com. That's poisonboyz.com. And you can also find us on Instagram and Facebook at Poison Boyz Apparel. And that again is, you know, @poisonboyz, and then that's apparel, APPARREL. Yo. Sorry.
There was more spelling on this fucking podcast, dude. That's so good.
But I just want to make sure you know that, because spellings get weird, you know, when people try to be looking things up.
Hey, dog. It took me to realize, like, I think not till like fucking episode like 40 something to start spelling out official, because I was like, go to official.com. I never fucking said it OHFISHL.com. Yeah. It's different than spelling it the real way, you know what I mean? So that's why I do it in the notes and shit. Go to official.com, OHFISHL.com. It's important to spell it if there's anything that's misspelled, even if it's just one fucking letter.
Or sometimes people can't, you know, like, understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you're like you're cloudy or whatever, I'm like, what am I saying again exactly? So,
would it be easy just be like, just go to poisonboyz.com. That's Poison Boyz with a Z.
Yeah, and then you honestly, and within the website, you can just go to the bottom, like any kind of website. You know, it's already linked to the Instagram, links and shit Facebook, like that. Exactly. Yeah.
Fucking A, so, man.
Yeah.
What's your handle, bro? Tell me your handle.
Holyg. Holy Grail.
Dude, like, I have to work that into the title somehow, bro. It's gonna be like Young Alva and the ABCs or some shit like that, dog. Yes, dude, spelling bees with Young Alva. Okay, dog. You can find me at casual520. That's K-A-Z-U-A-L 520. All across the board.
Yeah. DJ _Century everywhere.
And you can find us collectively at thehooddiner.com. And from there, you can get the links to every social that we're on. You can get the links to the Inner Circle. You can get the links to all our sponsors. And make sure you use code HOOD at all them bitches right there and get yourself some money off. You know what I'm saying? And this has been episode 68 of the Hood Diner Podcast.
I'm DJ Century.
And I am the homie Casual.
I'm DJ Alva.
Yeah.
Peace.
Of lives are controlled by a handful of men. Now, the truth can finally be told. The Inner Circle.